Hello, my realtor friends. If you are wanting to make a website and do that on Squarespace, I'm going to show you how to get started, how to make that happen, and do that as fast as possible so you can get back to selling and helping clients buy houses. So I went to squarespace.com/templates, and then I clicked on all templates because I know which one I'm going to use, so you can do the same. I'm going to do Command F and search for what is called the Sellwood template. This is going to be a very basic website. It's more of a landing page. So you can send people somewhere online, have a nice picture, a nice kind of online business card, if you will. This is going to accomplish that. So I'm going to click into Sellwood. Gives you some options to pick some color presets. I'm just gonna skip that. I'm gonna show you how to customize it for yourself in just a second. So let's just go start with this design. First thing it's going to ask you, there it is for your name. Put your name there. If you have a logo, we can add that in a second. Click next, and then I'm going to close. That's just showing you how to use Squarespace, but that's what I'm here for. So here we are. It will have customized your name up here in the top left. And now let me show you how to customize this page. I like to do things in a pretty particular order, so let's do that. The first thing we can do, let's go into edit mode, and I'm going to click edit site header, and this is where you can add that logo I was just talking about. Click the little pencil next to your name, and then you can drag and drop your logo in here. It would be best if that image is a PNG file, meaning it doesn't have like a white background, because with this template you can see it would be nice if it didn't have a background since the image is behind your name. Okay, while we are in the header, let's go over here to your social links. Again, click on those, and then there's a pencil button. You can see these are just linking out to Squarespace, which you do not want to do. So you can delete these if you don't want to use LinkedIn and Twitter, add socials, add Facebook, Instagram, whatever you might want to add here with your actual URLs. If you want to play around with the design, you can do that here. Otherwise, that's your socials. And then the contact me button, again, click on it, and then you will find a pencil icon. You should be sensing a theme by now. You can change this if you want to say email me or call me, whatever you want it to say, and then replace this email with your own. The design here, we will get into that in a minute. Don't worry about what color it is right now. I would just leave it as a primary button. Okay, so we've got your header set. I would hit save from there, and then I'm going to come over to this little paintbrush in the top right to access your site styles. I told you I like to do things in a particular order. I always like to get kind of like the basics in first and then go in and like start customizing and getting things to feel right for me. So to do that, I like to do fonts and colors first. If you have a set brand for your business, then you already know your fonts and your colors, you can do that, or you could spend all day searching through the many fonts that Squarespace offers. If I click into headings, for example, and then family, this is where you change your font. These two fonts here, it's just showing you what is being used right now on the website. But if I click browse all fonts, here are all the fonts that you have to choose from. There are a lot. I would just remind you, you can either one, check out my font video, two, don't pick something so crazy. You want people to be able to read your website quickly and easily. So find something that you like, but make sure it's easy to read. Back to headings. This is where you can control your font size. I guess there's nothing that's heading one. There we go. When you change it over here, you can see it change immediately on your page. Let's go back. And then go through paragraphs, buttons, and miscellaneous so that you're using just two fonts, preferably on your website. Then we'll go back to site styles and into colors. If you have brand colors, you can quickly add them by clicking the edit here and then just clicking on each of these dots and adding in your colors. Again, I have a whole nother video on picking colors, but the quick run down here is that for these five little color bubbles here, you want a white or something very close to it, a light, an accent, a dark, and a black or something very close to black. So that's how you're going to customize these to make a good looking website or little landing page here for you. If you want to, you can click here and drag this around. This website doesn't use a lot of colors. It looks like it's using this middle color here for your buttons. So let's say I want to customize that. And you can see, again, that change take place immediately over in your design. So you can change your color codes like this. You can look for presets down here. Or if you don't have brand color, something that might be fun for this template, if you know what picture you want to put here in the background, you can click over here on the from image, drop that image in there, and then pull colors directly from that image so everything flows together nicely with your colors. Okay, back, close. Let's save the fonts and colors that we just picked. And now you get to just customize the text. It's super simple. You just click in the box and type what you want it to say. And if you want to change the size of the box, you just click and pull and drag just like that. And down here, they have another text box. I would probably make that the same width. That's just me. I would make these all the same width. You can customize this text the same way. And just because I have my Realtor license as well, I think there's something missing on this template that I want to remind you about, that you need to put your broker information and phone number on here and whatever else your broker or your state might require. Customize that. If you want to add a section down here in the footer, this might be a good spot to put that contact information. You can pick from any of these layouts here that might make sense to you. We already have the sign up box on the page, so I'd probably go with something more simple. I'm gonna click back on the page to edit. You could put it here if you want, whatever feels right to you. And then the sign up, if you want to collect people's email addresses, so they all they got to do is put in their email and then you can reach out to them. Then click this little pencil icon. You could change the title of it, add a description, disclaimer if you like. If you want to ask for their name as well, you could do that. Under post submit, you can add a little message here like, thank you, I will email or call or whatever. I guess email if you're collecting their name and email. I will email you shortly. Back under design, you might want to stack those so that they're all in a line. You can center if you'd like, add a background color if you'd like. Lots of options here. And then you want to make sure that you know where those email addresses are going. By default, they will be collected on the back end of your Squarespace website. You can also go to other storage options, and MailChimp is one that I use the most with my clients. So connect whatever email list you would like to use. Or if you saw here, you can put them all in a Google Drive in a spreadsheet. Okay. That is the text content of your page. Now let's work on that background image. So you can see when I'm just hovering over this picture, if I click edit section background, you can see that's where the picture lives. I always just hit the delete button. You can hit replace, whatever you want to do. Delete, if you have an image, drag and drop it in. If you don't, totally fine. Let me show you this. Click the plus button, browse stock images. All these images are free for you to use on your website. I'm just going to type in house. Here you go. You can just search for whatever feels right to you and add it to your website. I'm gonna go with a super modern house with a pool. Why not? And that is how easy that is. Kind of goes with my color, don't you think? The pool? Okay, so this little circle icon here will allow you to not crop the image, but show what part of the image you want. So if it's cropping in a weird way, then just move the circle around rather than editing the actual image itself. Under colors, this is where you can change all the different defaults that Squarespace has. So they're just using your colors in all these different ways. You can go through and see which one is the easiest to read, looks the best to you. I'm gonna go with dark one. Come back to background, and then you can change how much of that black background is going to go over the picture or not. So that is how you edit this super simple landing page. I'm going to just, you see, I just drag and drop and pull to select all of this. I'm gonna move it up. Since I added the name and email field, it got a little longer. Pull that up. Don't have to scroll as much, but this is how you use Squarespace and this cell wood template. Exit, and there is your customized Realtor homepage. The next steps you need to take once you have this design the way you like it, you will need to subscribe to Squarespace, which means you're paying for your hosting and for this website. Once you're on a paid plan, which if you want my discount, I will link to that below. You can and you need to connect your domain name to go live. So over here on the left sidebar, come to settings, domains and email, and domains, and you can either get a new domain or use one that you already have and connect it to this new website. It will likely walk you through this process when you subscribe and pay Squarespace, but if it doesn't, or if you want to do it later, this is where you find it. And that, I believe, is all I have for you in this tutorial. If you have any other questions about setting up your website landing page, let me know. You can also check out all the other videos I have on my channel. Lots of Squarespace tutorials for you to check out. And leave me a comment if you have a question. Otherwise, I will see you in the next video.